Okay, so what's in between fame and riches on the web? Well, what's in between fame and riches is people pouring a lot of money into your company because they believe you're going to be rich someday. They know you're famous, otherwise they wouldn't be paying attention to you at all. They know you have something that they think is going to be really big, the billion-dollar idea, and so they want to get in early. They want to invest. So let's look at another clip from The Social Network where you see the beginning of that phase, going from we're just trying to do this, we're two guys in the back room, to we're now on the path to being rich as well as famous.
Sean, he'll be right with you.
No problem. You know this is where they filmed Towering Inferno?
That's comforting.
Hey guys, come on back. She offer you some water?
Oh yeah, we're cool.
Sean, away. Come on in. Must be Mark.
Hi.
We took a look at everything and congratulations. We're gonna start you off with a $500,000 investment. Maurice is gonna talk to you about some corporate restructuring.
We'll file as a corporation in Delaware. Come up with a stock structure that allows for new investors.
Now, let me ask you something. Who's Eduardo Saverin?
So notice the juxtaposition of cultures, and that's in the clip from The Social Network. That's so true about the entire new era of wealth, where wealth is coming from the geeks, wealth is coming from people who are socially inept, wealth is coming from people who weren't necessarily born into it, although you'd be surprised how many people who've gotten rich on the web actually were born into wealth. So one story that I'll tell along these lines is, this is a scene that I saw outside of Microsoft when it was still relatively small, and not all that rich just yet. So the scene is this. Guy in cut-off jeans, bare feet, ripped up t-shirt, walking out of the front door of one of the Microsoft offices. At this time, no security on Microsoft at all. You could just walk in and out of Microsoft at will. And in front of him were two men in suits, maybe in their late 40s to early 50s, opening the door for this kid, basically, in cut-off jeans, bare feet, and ripped up shirt. And the guys in suits, as they're opening the door, they're saying to this young kid, so do you think we'll get a call back from you? And the young kid is saying, yeah, I don't know, whatever. Ciao, see you later. And they walk out the door and they look a little bit downcast. That's the role reversal that's happened, where the young geeks are now on top and the old establishment suits and ties are catering to those ideas because they know that those are the ones that are going to make money. So this is the road for Facebook as well as any other application. They get famous first. They get looked at by the people with money. The people with money start pouring a lot of money into them. And you can see from the slide exactly who has poured money into Facebook. But interestingly, the vast majority of the money that's come from Facebook actually has really devolved from Mark Zuckerberg giving portions of the equity of the company, the equity meaning the ownership of the company, to various constituencies, chief among them the staff of Facebook. And that's what's in it for people who work at these companies. If they get in early, they get a little piece of the growth of the company, they get some of the stock of the company. When that stock of the company goes through the roof, they go through the roof with it. So can you imagine owning just 5% of Facebook and having that be worth, what is it, $5 billion? A lot of money.